I'm in the wilderness. I just hit two in the water. Flub one.
Honestly, I've never seen them this in the wilderness before. This would be a good walk for them.
Money round day.
It's money round.
Does anybody peek their head outside?
No, but I checked the weather. I think we're gonna be fine.
Really?
Well, I think it's gonna rain hard for like an hour, but it's gonna be good on either side.
Get loose. Shameless plug, courtesy of KSM Sports.
Listen, we're not doing that.
Listen,
no, we're not
RC
doing
Cunk
that.
Up in Cincy, not, that, or in
that's
Columbus,
not what this is
for you, big guy.
That's not what this is about. Looks a little rich for our blood, huh?
I was thinking about going belt on the outside here. Really classing it up.
On the outside of your rain pants?
Yeah.
I know you could do that.
We'd like to introduce additional downside to the money round.
Tomorrow we have to play the money round from the tips.
Oh God.
First of all, the yardage from the tips tomorrow is 69.69. Okay. So a little bit of good news. The weekday rate, $28.32 each.
Hey, so we save $6 basically?
Yeah. The card's for Mr. DJ, our cameraman.
Wet your beak with some coffee?
I want to assure everybody that's community coffee. The guy said I could help myself.
How could you look out for the kid?
The big storyline today, Neil's got one golf ball left. Did they sell Callaways inside?
Oh, yeah. I didn't check.
No, I checked. They do. You're not going to lose a ball, so don't even worry about it.
Yeah, let's go. My course handicap's an 8. So take 36 minus 8. I need to get 28 points. Okay, so bogeys are worth a point in the quota game. Pars are worth 2. Birdies are worth
4.
4. And eagles 8. Yeah.
We can't lose our ass. That's our only thing.
Don't think that way. Don't say that.
It'll work. What's the strategy today, by the way?
Just keep it in play.
Oh boy. That is right and going right.
Ew. It's probably up, yeah, because it's so wet over there.
Okay.
Hey, that's a good start.
Can I tell you?
Yeah.
It's right where you are.
Yeah, I know.
Saved by St. Raphia.
Or down.
Thin to win.
Great four.
What'd you think of the golf course today? It's kind of awakens a feeling in me that I'm having a tough time putting words to. I know that course. It's like the minute I stepped on it, I was like, I've played this course 100 times. It's like every subdivision course I played growing up. As I get older and I play more golf that's not like that, it's like you go back and play a course like that, and when you see one that's done well, you're like, oh, like this style, this is like that style of subdivision development course, but done really well. No force carries. It was long but fair. Like, I felt like it was a good golf course.
OB.
But it's like Neil's first one is in. What happened back by the houses there?
What happened was my hitter big guy himself found us a Callaway Hex Control. It's a throwback.
Subtle.
Kill it. Kill it. Kill it.
Great shot.
Kind of looked like at the end.
Oh, that's a frustrating one.
We just gotta keep fighting.
Yep.
So,
now Tyler's.
Oh, I get stroked.
Yeah, man. Just a little sustenance. We're keeping it light. Yeah, we've accumulated 19 of 49 points.
But you know what? We're not out of it.
No. For sure.
We're behind schedule, but a couple birdies would change stuff. So.
All right, let's go get it.
Back now, boys.
I was thinking about on the last green, and it gives me vibes of the 1990s when gated communities and was in, and golf courses were like, let's just build as many as we can, man. Water everywhere.
Here's Neil's ball at the 12th.
Hey, rubber the green there.
You're all right.
That's a major, major victory.
That was heavy carry there, huh?
That was pretty good.
Alright, Neil.
Things are moving quickly for Neil. He's seen two come back to his feet.
Neil's absolutely opus day. Like, he loves to beat himself up mentally. He's gotta get out of his own head.
Which I think he's trying to do.
He's just like, I can just see him getting plowed by a high-speed freight train right now. We're going to pick him up. We need him. We need a couple pars out of him. We need a birdie out of him down the stretch.
How's the radar like?
Yeah, we got a little weather moving in. We're the blue pin.
Okay.
So, I mean, we got a little time. I don't know if we got 4 holes worth of time.
Should we haul ass?
I mean, it'd be preferable to haul ass.
All right, let's do that. Okay. It appears that these boys are down to their last ball each. Oh God. We've run out of golf balls.
I just hold out. So he now hold, I gotta,
Randy hold out. He's gonna let Neil play with that ball for the remainder of the hole. What if he chunks this in the water?
It's not gonna be good. I honestly off the shot.
Very safe. That's gonna be a double.
I'm in the wilderness. I just hit 2 in the water. Flop one.
I made a bad double there. We got 1 ball between us. We don't know what to do. The storms are coming in. I mean, we're gonna need to sleep for tomorrow, right?
Yeah. Let's do that.
Okay.
Alright.
Honestly, I've never seen him this in the wilderness before. I feel like it's a little bit of a self-fulfilling prophecy. Like, I feel like he's been beating himself up, flogging himself until now. Like, now it's come to fruition. Like, now he actually is playing terribly. This will be a good walk for him.
Was St. Rapio with you guys today? I wanted to just scream at St. Rapio, like, you know, look at the footsteps, dude. Like, when I had my toughest time on 15, look, there's only 1 set in the dew. There's only 1 set of footsteps.
In the mud.
In the muck.
In the mire.
In the mire. You fucking bailed on me. It was Rapia. And you know what he said? No, Hickory, no.
No.
As you fell to earth, that's when I carried you.
Well, I got chrome softs. They're $12.05. So we got 3 more balls. That's not my game, man. you know, quad, triple, double the last three holes is, it's going to take a toll.
Neil and I's total points right now is at 30. Our quota is 49, so we're 19 short. Times two is $38. Now, there's money to be had out there on those last three holes. 16's a 393-yard par 4. 17's the second easiest, but it's still like 180 par 3. And then 18 looks a little gettable, maybe. 515 par 5. Ugh, a lot of water.
Looks like the only force carry of the day.
It's really not as heavy. It's dissipated a little bit because it is raining, but it's not like, it's really not thunder and lightning.
So, you know what? Let's think about it this way. Let's go win our lunch. Yeah. I mean, there's 10 to 12 bucks out there for us if we go string together three pars.
The sanctions, would you say you're feeling them?
Yeah, the two balls is tough.
Honestly, I think they're bullshit.
But one, that was so poor by me. I didn't need to hit three wood there, and I did. It's like I'm spiting myself a little bit out there. Oh, yeah, you shouldn't hit three wood. Well, you're gonna. Let's see what happens. I'm at war with myself internally. And I'm not winning.
Nobody wins.
Yeah. Everybody's a year collateral damage. Looks like it's getting sunny out there.
Nope, didn't complete the swing.
Fucked.
Well, we got three of them.
Back. God, it feels good.
Oh, good putt.
Points, that's 12 right there.
That's 6 points, $12.
I think we spot St. Rapio right through the trees.
Yeah, I feel like St. Rapio was with him.
I think he had to be.
When we needed him most, I feel like he was.
Great swing.
I think the kid's back.
He's got 165 into the closing par 5 here from the back tee.
A little soggy. There, what do you think?
What's your normal eight distance?
165? 160?
Yeah, hit a big nine.
Great shot.
Couple
grooves low. Let's go. God, that I almost topped it in the water.
But we got an eagle putt.
But we're putting for eagle.
First of the trip.
I had it at a minimum.
Yeah, I think that's perfect. For eagle, do it.
Just
let's go. God, that feels good.
Hey, thank you. Finish.
Let's go, huh?
Huh?
What do you say, Randy? Three under on the last two?
Is that good?
Hey, come here. We'll worry about that ball later.
Hey, listen, that's 16 bucks. We can do all kinds of stuff at lunch now.
Oh, he is 45 points, just four short of our quota.
Just $8 short.
Four short of our quota?
Yeah.
Man, we battled our fucking dicks off. Quad, triple, double, triple, birdie, eagle over the last six.
It's the microwave, man.
That is awesome.
You shot 88. I shot a 92, 37, 76 for Deej.
Yo.
At 15 points, we got 30 bucks after that little
fuck yeah,
intermission.
Dude.
That's more, hey, let's go get a good lunch.
Yeah, let's go.
The best place to eat in Baton Rouge, in my humble opinion, is called Elsie's Plate and Pie. Literally, and I am not exaggerating, if I was on death row and I had one meal to go, it would be the Boudin burger at Elsie's, which is a burger patty. And then, you know, between a brioche bun, you've got a burger patty, smoked Gouda, and a patty of Boudin, which is like sausage and rice. And it is out of this world. It is the best thing I've ever eaten.
Earn your shit. That's my eagle right there on the plate. I got an eagle for lunch.
Lunch got away from us, $63. We had to have a couple pies.
Why does this always happen?
I don't know, man. Like, you don't really think about, like, the tip. That's, you know, that's $10. That shit adds up. I mean, that was totally unnecessary. What are we doing?
So you're gonna need at least 100 for a place to stay?
70 for golf, and we got like $30 left, dude.
Dude, that's
not a lot.
Well, there's nothing we can do now.
Yeah, no, we just didn't talk about it. Like, we just would assume that dessert wasn't gonna run us. What the fuck are we doing, dude? What are we doing?
Hold on, though. Was it good?
The pies were awesome. Maybe the highlight of the trip.
We're in the moment, guys.
Listen, man, I'm borrowing happiness from the future, yeah. Right?
Hey, guys.
Hey, party boys.
So, yeah, we are leaving the Red Stick right now. That's English for Baton Rouge, if you didn't know that. Rose to the occasion today. We lost $8 in the money round. I finished the round going quad, triple, double, triple, birdie, eagle. That's how I finished today.
How did you only lose $8?
Because you don't get punished for doubles, triples, and quads in the quota game. You get rewarded for good play. It's like the ACT.
Yeah.
You don't go wrong if you answer all the questions. There's nothing.
You might
nothing
as well at least
subtracted.
Guess.
We lost all the balls. I lost
it going.
$5.
Yeah, it's five.
Well,
balls.
Yeah, it's $12.50. How does that sound?
So, how many balls do you guys have left?
One each.
Yeah.
Do you think that's gonna last you?
Probably not. I mean, we hope so.
Where are you guys staying tonight?
Well, we don't know.
We don't know yet. So we gotta figure that out.
Hey, stay safe, alright?
Yeah, I know.
But save enough money to bring us back a souvenir.
Yeah. That too. We may look up Maggie, who is
we gotta find out more about her from DJ.
Yeah. And you know Maggie?
I don't know Maggie, no. I was having dinner with Shane Bacon recently. I told him I was on the way to New Orleans. He said, you have to hang out with my friend Maggie.
Okay. What is she? She's a singer, obviously.
She's a musician.
She lives there?
She lives there.
Okay.
She's graciously agreed to show us around her city.
Okay, cool. I love being
I didn't need a tour guide.
Around by a local.
Maybe she can point us in the right direction as far as like what part of town.
Well, that's my thing.
I don't want to get an Airbnb like in the wrong part of town.
First of all, I'm kind of feeling this.
Yeah, turn it up.
Smoky and love it. Same. Ooh, baby, you walk right through me. 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 Like that old abandoned shotgun sitting up on Esplanade. I didn't know you till I left you. I didn't care till I was gone. Cause it's all.
How the fuck did we end up? We're gonna go hunt some birds.
This is huge. Thank you.
You're welcome.